Good evening. Welcome to Face to Face. Traders and entrepreneurs have been a part of indigenous culture since long before Europeans arrived. Fur trading networks were built on top of long-established trade routes already in existence. Tonight, I talk with Kevin Brownlee, a Métis man and the curator of archaeology for the Manitoba Museum.
Recently, Indian Country Today, which is a magazine down in the States, broke a story that about a dozen Native American actors and extras were...
What's odd is that nobody's talking about future prime ministers. And if you're worried about the power Mr. Harper has, you should be attacking the power of the position, you know, as well as the person who's in there now that you may or may not like. We did just wrap up our summer break, so we are kind of clearing up some of the important activities that happened over that timeline. One of the things that happened was the Oka Crisis, or the 25th anniversary of that event. The Oka Crisis started in July 1990, when the community of Oka, through a golf course, started to expand onto Ganasetage lands. So let's start with Jerry. Jerry, do you remember where you were when the...
We feel the same way. In fact, we have some local activists we spoke to a while ago that said if they put Syrian refugees in Kapyong, they're going to go and sort of occupy Kapyong in order to make certain that doesn't happen. So it's an interesting thing. Candy, real quick, we only got about 10 seconds. Your thoughts on the refugees?
The cultural village here at the Nay Games not only showcases cultures that are specific to the mainland of Turtle Island, but Larissa Burnoff had a chance to meet our tropical island cousins as well.
1 month before the Nay Games started, the host society had to cancel all the swimming events because not enough officials could be found. But Larissa Burnoff has the incredible story of how the teams came together to solve the problem and make sure that their kids can compete. Tonight, we're going to introduce you to a young man from the Northwest Territories. He's already won 2 gold in canoeing for his team, and he's paddling for a third. We'll also take you to the cultural village. Winique and I will hear from an elder who has traveled far to be at these games. She's going to tell us about her land and her people. And it takes a lot of time, effort, and organization to put on an event this size. We're going to meet Dave Canadian, who is the chair of the North American Indigenous Games Board. And he'll tell us about what these games are about and what they've done over the years. And of course, every day there is entertainment here at the First Nation University of Canada grounds. Last night we had on Crystal Shawanda and Manitoba's own Donna Merrow. So we'll bring you some of the sights and sounds from the entertainment here at the Nay Games. Now I have with me 2 young ladies who are playing softball for Team Manitoba. Can I get your names, please?
Renee Garson.
And Janessa McKay.
Okay, can you ladies tell me, you know, how have you been enjoying the game so far?
Good, it's been fun.
Yeah?
Yeah,
it's been awesome.
Have you met anybody new? Have you been making connections with people from all across Turtle Island?
Yeah, we met a couple people from Yukon, Northwest Territories.
Ontario.
Okay. Yeah. Well, you know, you guys are just heading into practice, so you haven't played any games yet. Are you guys looking, do you think your chances are good to bring home a medal for Team Manitoba in the softball event?
Yeah, I think we could do it as long as we play as a team and support each other.
Okay.
And communicate with each other.
Yeah.
And play hard.
Why is communication so important on the field?
So you know what you're doing and know who you're passing to.
Yeah, it sounds like it's fairly important. Did you guys want to give a shout out to anybody back in Manitoba?
Like to say hi to my mom and dad, my nieces and nephew. I miss you guys.
And hi to my dad and uncle. I hope you guys are watching and I'll play hard for you guys.
All right, back to you, Fran, from the North American Indigenous Games here at the First Nation University in Regina. Good evening. Welcome to APTN National News. It's being called the first treaty signing among First Nations since the 19th century. Today, simultaneously in Montreal and Vancouver, chiefs signed a declaration that is likely going to make governments and the oil industry nervous. We have 2 stories tonight. We start with Tom Fenario in Montreal. He explains what this treaty is all about. That's how we saw Turtle Island tonight. Stay tuned for an encore presentation of APTN Investigates. I'm Michael Hutchinson. Have a good one.